Hey, what's up guys? Caleb here from Aylsworth Razors. Welcome to the channel, or welcome back. It's been quite a minute since I've done one of these shave videos, but I got a couple new things in the den, and I really wanted to do a nice Christmas shave. So, first up, we're going to be taking a look at this lovely addition right here, which is Santa's Cheer from MacDuff Soap Company. For the brush, we're going to be looking at this beautiful red anodized aluminum Altare brush from Aylsworth Razors. And for the star of the show, we're going to be looking at the all new Apex three-piece razor just released last Friday. Okay, so since this is a new razor on the channel, we're gonna do this a little bit differently. Normally I talk about the soaps first, but I'm gonna go ahead and take a look at this razor first and just talk about some of the specs on it. So as you can see right here, this is a three-piece razor in 316 stainless steel. It is 106 grams in weight and 3.5 inch handle length. The finish on it is bead blast, but it also has a light electro polish to it. So rather than being one of those kind of typical matte sort of bead blasts, it has that matte finish quality to it, kind of pristine without all the machine marks, but it's got a nice sheen to it as well. As you can see, there's the handle. The handle pattern is designed in such a way as to kind of carry over some of our trademark Aylsworth handle aesthetic. We've got the vertical flutes here. We've also got this kind of helix pattern, except we played around with, you know, the dimensions of the various different flutes and spiral patterns to give it a different look. Where the former Dracant handle kind of looked like a grenade, I find this one looks a little bit more like a racing car tire. It's very, very grippy in the hand. Here's the top cap. One of the other changes that we've done here is our former kind of Dracant top cap has the round post holes or blade posts. This one has the pill-shaped blade posts and the pill-shaped slots for them to slot into. They're also invisible, so they don't go all the way through the plate, which is, you know, a nice little feature. They're very, very, very high tolerance. So if you take them here and you try to wiggle them, there's no play whatsoever. Just locks right in, but it's still very smooth to assemble. Very wide lather channels on this base plate. You can see they're very large. They go straight across. No trouble clearing this at all. And we'll see that later with the shave. I've got quite a bit of fur going on here, so we'll see how that holds up. That is the look right there. Also, we have our trademark A plus engraving, and it also says Aylsworth Razors around the slot for the washer and handle. Let's go ahead and get a blade in there. I'm gonna be using one of my go-to Gillette Platinum blades. These are my favorite blades, and with the amount of fur I have going on, figure might as well get a nice fresh blade in there. So there we go. Blade set on those posts. Go ahead and drop that base plate in there, and we'll cinch that up. Another thing you'll note with this is the threading is very, very, very high tolerance as well. There's no wiggle there, even when not fully assembled. And this clamping on the blade is best in class. I would say there is almost no razor out there that has clamping quite as extensive as this, or cutting edge support on the blade as well. All right, let's wet the face and go ahead and get some of that lather on there. So again, for the brush, we're gonna be using this aluminum Altare brush. You can see we've got our nice lather worked up here already. Now for this brush, the Altare brush has been out for just about a year now, but only available in black. And these red brushes are not available yet, but they shall be available very early in the new year, along with a number of other colors. I personally really like the look of it. I find the colored anodization to be very beautiful on that 6063 architectural grade aluminum, and they are very affordable price at $59 US for the handle only. They come with a couple of knot options too. We have the G5C synthetic and also our own custom AR1 Badger knot. And as you can see, it just handles very, very well in the hand. This kind of flare and the ferrule around it gives a really nice grip. It's hollowed out on the inside, so the weight is not too excessive, although it does have a little bit of heft to it because it is made out of architectural grade aluminum. But I would say, you know, it actually kind of comes in at a similar weight to a lot of the handmade wood and resin brushes that you will see out there as well. A lot of people who own one of the black ones have said that it is one of their favorite razors to handle. Here we go. So this is a first pass with the Apex razor. Now this, we're going on 8 days of growth. I did a live shave just before launch with 8 days of growth against the Apex, and it did not stand a chance. There was no buffing that was needed. It was a regular three-pass shave with very few pickups, and it was a nice BBS. You can see that was almost no work there to go through that 8 days worth of growth. The specs on paper for this razor are a 0.99 millimeter blade gap, so nearly a millimeter of gap and 0.125 millimeter exposure. And that may seem intimidating to some, especially with the efficiency that you're getting, but the blade feel is very, very minimal. you can tell it's there, but it's not threatening at all. And the early feedback has been that it's some kind of sorcery. Given the amount of efficiency and how little blade feel there is. There you can see too, those lather channels are just clearing perfectly. I've only had to rinse once so far, and to be honest, that was probably more out of habit than necessity. I'm gonna go ahead and just see how long I can go before I have to start rinsing this thing. There we go, right through that huge patch of growth. Done the whole side of the neck here now too. I think it's about time for me to start rinsing this thing because it's collecting full of lather, but there's no clogging there happening whatsoever with all that hair and lather. I will say it did go through that 8 days of growth a little bit more smoothly on the other side once I did rinse the razor. Basically one long stroke right through it. But yeah, very, very high efficiency. Almost astonishingly so, again, given the level of comfort and low blade feel. All right, let's go in for pass number two against the grain. The soap for this shave, that was Santa's Cheer by MacDuff Soap Company. You'll notice I'm going for against the grain on the second pass rather than across the grain as well. The blade clamping is such that there's no blade chatter, so you can just go straight up like that against the grain, No irritation, nothing. But yes, yeah, Santa's Cheer by MacDuffs. It's part of a multi-part Santa series being released this holiday. Been out for a little while already. The price point on it is, I want to say $26 Canadian, around $22, $23 US, and $22.50 for the splash Canadian, and around $18 or $19 US, I think, for the splash. So under $50 Canadian dollars for the set. As always, MacDuff's has a great soap base, a little bit soft. I bowl lather, so it's not an issue, but if you tub lather, be careful. Because there is some danger of overloading when you're tub lathering with MacDuff's. The scent notes are wonderful. I had the opportunity to smell this directly before it was released. I met up with Sean from MacDuff's at the Idaho Falls meetup, and he let me get my nose on it, and I just fell in love with it immediately. The scent notes, I believe, are amaretto, sweet rum, vanilla. Then there's cream, butter, sugar, and cinnamon. So kind of like a nice holiday cookie fragrance already. And then we've got nutmeg, cardamom, allspice, and tonka bean in the base. And I don't know why, but somehow with this combination, I get a bit of almost an apple note to it. Maybe it's the cinnamon and some of the sweetness, but there's a bit of an apple note to it too. So it kind of gives me this feeling of like cider, holiday cider, and then eggnog. And I love eggnog and I love holiday fragrances. And MacDuff's does a gourmand fragrance like no other. You know, MacDuff's has a couple wheelhouses. If you collect MacDuff's soaps, you'll know he does a great kind of woodsy evergreen. And then he does a really, really good sort of boozy kind of fragrance, and then of course the gourmands, and this one is no exception. It is fantastic. And I'm gonna go in for a quick third pass, even though I checked it there in between and I don't really need one. We're already there after two passes, but I'm just gonna get this third one in there, maybe do like a pickup in my trouble spot under the neck there. Although as trouble spots go, it was already pretty BBS down there, but I'm gonna do it just for fun and due diligence here. But if you listen to the audible feedback here, you're not hearing much cutting. More scraping the blade across, you know, bare skin. There's a little bit of cutting right there in that kind of trouble spot in my divot under my neck. And right there as well. But very, very little. And there we go. Three passes in. No nicks, cuts, or weepers, no irritation. 8 days growth gone just like that. Okay, let's throw on that Santa's Cheer splash. This is a non-alcoholic splash, witch hazel, but MacDuff's splashes always do a fantastic job of rounding out that journey. I can't wait to wear this fragrance all day. It's just gorgeous. Just smells like cookies and eggnog. Oh yeah, that's beautiful. Love it. If you guys like a nice holiday gourmand fragrance, I cannot recommend this one enough. Okay, So let's just do the quick recap here. Just give my brush a quick rinse there. So again, for the soap, that was MacDuff's Santa's Cheer. Fantastic, first outing with it. For the brush, right here we've got that red Altare 6063 aluminum architectural grade anodized red. That should be available early in the new year. And then for the razor, we have the Apex. That is a three-piece razor, very high efficiency, very, very smooth and comfortable here. And this released last Friday on the 1st of December. I believe we're now around the 5th as I'm recording this. Few days left to order this. We're gonna have our holiday shutdown on the 14th. So if you did wanna grab one, there'll be a link down below for this as well as the MacDuff Santa's Cheer. And these are available for $149 US, $199 Canadian with free shipping to USA and Canada. Looks like I did ding myself on the Adam's apple. But yes, that's it. Thank you so much for tuning in. If I don't see you before the holidays, I'm wishing you all a very, very Merry Christmas and a happy holiday. And thanks again for tuning in. I appreciate you and I'll see you in the next video.